Okay, what was that with the 25?
Okay, so hello and welcome everybody to FAQ Crew Session 26. Last time you went, were you on your way back from Valaki to Krezk and took a break at the tower at Lake Baratok, where at night you were attacked by a pack of werewolves and wolves, and you fought them in a exciting battle in which one of you got infected by lycanthropy.
Again.
And you ended up with leveling up and are now standing on the land bridge that connects the country and the island that the tower is on.
Oh, should I prepare a spell that's going to help with that? Or Ludo can take care of himself, right?
I have the spell. I don't need your help.
Okay, I'm just checking. God.
Well, just to be to remember correctly, the wolves were not all dead, some fled, right?
No, they all killed
all of them.
Oh,
one ran away and then got killed by a Ludo.
Yep. Okay. Guiding bolt has a long range.
Yeah. That's good.
First, I'd like to see if the lead wolf, which I killed, does he have anything on him, like any instructions, any items? Can I basically loot him?
Let me just check if there's anything interesting to find. Well, the wolves are just wolves, so yeah. Nothing there.
If the same Burgomaster existed, we could have like taken their teeth and gotten them.
I mean, if you want to, you can get furs and stuff.
Yeah, do you guys want furs?
Like a wolf fur cape?
Yeah, I'll skin them. I'll try and skin them.
Oh my god, that'd be so cool, actually.
Yeah, I'm gonna...
Make a survival check.
Till is gonna go back to sleep because it's in the middle of the night.
20!
Okay, so you can extract big parts of fur from the wolves, and let me give you a total here. About 13 teeth.
Ooh. Fur and 13 teeth.
We had a whole bunch
I'm
of
just going
to
equip a little bit of fur as well. Cover Till's couch.
Sorry, Sylvia.
You get a wolf fur covering for your couch.
Oh, I thought you were mean. But that's nice.
How was I going to be mean with it?
No, I understood something else. I thought you wanted to cover Tylmirk with something gross.
Oh.
Oh, no.
While he's sleeping. That's nice. Yeah. Thank you.
And you find the werewolves each had a spear, which returns when they turn back into human form.
Oh, I thought it meant they like returned to them, and I was like... Ooh, spear?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That would be a spear.
How many spears?
How many werewolves were there? Do you remember? I don't know. I think nine. There
were 15 total enemies.
There were 15 total.
Yes, but not all were wolves.
Eight of them were wolves,
I think five
were
werewolves, plus the big leader.
There were two groups. One group was four wolves, the other one was...
Hold on.
Three or four
wolves. Do have...
There were, four werewolves.
Notes on that battle here. One, two...
Oh, battle
wolves. There were six werewolves plus the leader, so you have seven spears.
Oh my god, I have so many spears, guys.
I was just about to say, I mean, you're an arsenal at this point.
You're like a porcupine,
I'm just hugging all my new spears, and I'm like, oh, this one's bloodied. Oh, so great.
fast forward like 20 years, Sharn's in a house full of fucking spears.
Yeah.
My fence will be made of spears.
Yeah, the fence is spears of her enemies that she's killed.
And they did, for some reason, have quite a lot of treasure on them.
Ooh.
You do find. Somebody take this down.
Oh, shit. Sure. I will take this down.
800 copper pieces.
Okay, somebody else take the money down.
Yep.
8,000 silver pieces.
Oh, fuck.
Shit. Enough money for wolves.
Yeah.
Did
they have a wolf market?
600 gold pieces.
Right, 13. Oh, yeah, you're already down. Cool.
120 platinum pieces.
Wow.
Holy shit.
These wolves were loaded.
Yep.
What the hell?
Why are werewolves so fucking rich?
Well...
I'm so confused.
Oh, yes.
There is a reason.
That with all our other money, we like...
We are rich.
Yeah.
So rich, we don't have a single good shop to find any of the things.
11 gems worth 10 gold each. And 4 small-ish potion bottles, where you have currently no idea what's in it.
Nice.
They're not
Can
labeled.
I do a check on it? Can I have a look at the...
You can make an arcana check, yeah.
Okay. Oh, I'm so upstairs, aren't I?
4 arcana checks, actually.
4?
Yes.
I don't suppose I can actually get downstairs right now, you know, because the platform will be on the bottom.
But you can call to the... You know the activation word for the golems.
Oh, true. I will say that word I've forgotten right now.
Me too.
But my character hasn't.
And go down. Okay, so I got...
Please.
A 9 for the first one.
Yeah, no.
And then 2 17s and then a 21.
Okay, so you get the other... the first one kind of eludes you. That's...
No, I don't know what this is.
That stuff is weird.
What's the color so that we can just mark it in our inventory?
Okay, so the first one you do identify is a potion of fire giant strength.
Oh, yeah.
Fuck, I want that.
I would like to say we are not giving that to Roth under any circumstance.
That gives whoever drinks it a strength score of 25 for 1 hour.
Fuck, I want that for Till. Holy fuck.
Like everyone wants
for
that.
1 hour?
For 1 hour.
Yeah. How amazing would that be?
And the other two you identify are actually identical. And they are potions of invulnerability.
Oh, those are nice. Those are
Really important.
Which
I suggest we give one of those to Ted.
Which gives resistance to all damage for 1 minute.
That's cool.
Only resistance, but still.
Well, still, if you have 34 hit points, it's a good thing.
Yeah. So basically that doubles your hit point count.
Yeah.
We'll put this all in the bag holding for now and discuss when...
We've got to sort out the bag holding.
The leader doesn't have any, like, instructions on him or anything like that.
Nope. Okay, and there is one smaller bottle with a cloudy gray liquid that you have no idea what it is.
If I join them downstairs, can I make a check to see what it looks like?
Yeah, make an arcana check. Sure.
All these vials remind me that I need to make poison.
21. Yes.
Okay, you take a look again. You have actually heard of that. That's oil of etherealness.
Ooh.
It can cover a medium or smaller creature alongside equipment. Takes 10 minutes to apply. And it gives you the effect of the etherealness spell for 1 hour. Yeah, for 1 hour.
That's cool.
Which means...
Again, something I think Till could use to best effect.
I'm not sure if that's for me. Because I have ways to get around anyways.
Yeah, no, but like if you get attacked while you're alone. I mean, like, if we want to send you out for a scouting mission.
That's true. But but I think that's more if I find a way that none of you can come with. And if you're ethereal, you can. Or something like that.
So you can move everywhere, see everything in black and white, but nobody else can see you, nobody can affect you.
Yeah.
You can.
That's a good thing.
It's good for scouting.
Yeah.
Maybe like Io
would have it.
Io would be.
Yeah, I think Io and.
That sounds like fun.
Yeah, because.
Then Bug can't go on his own.
You can also move up and down with that spell on the material plane. So you can go through walls, ceilings, floors.
That's perfect for
you.
For
just
IO,
have to remember to get back to where you started from, because otherwise you'll pop up where you are at that moment.
Mm. Yeah.
True. Get to safety.
Yeah.
Within an hour.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah.
Well, that's the same thing as my invisibility. If I'm not out of there in 1 hour, I'm fucked.
Yeah.
Cool.
But with that
would be an interesting way to start a fight.
But with that, you could technically be 200 feet up in the air with the etherealness, and then...
Yeah. Yes.
Oof. Can you imagine?
I'll catch you, don't worry.
Let's not do that. I don't...
if you take the giant strength potion in time...
Yeah, I'll chuck down the fire strength.
Actually, it's true.
Just every single potion at once, like magic.
That's maybe not the best.
That's not the best idea.
There may be consequences with taking too many potions at
once.
Please don't die. Potion cocktail.
Every DM will punish that, I
think.
Magic overdose. Yep. Magic
overdose. Be just like that rainbow puking gift.
Okay, so that's what you find. The potions are carried by the leader, by the way.
Why did he not use those?
A little bit. No, never mind.
Let's not question it. Let's choose.
That's a game flaw. Actually, yeah. When you determine loot at the end of a combat, it's like Wait.
Why did you not? No, that's cool. Maybe it's not his. He's holding it for a friend.
Or he was like, oh, this battle is going to go way worse. I'm going to keep holding on to this.
Yeah.
He forgot he had it.
Yeah.
Right.
It was in the bag of holding. He couldn't quite reach it.
Or maybe he just had no idea what it was.
Oh, yeah, true.
That's a good point.
Maybe his boss was like, here, take this. And he was like, okay.
I'll take it.
Sure. Sure.
Right.
What do you want? Are we agreed that Io should have... Do you want to divvy these up now, or...?
I mean, technically, Till is already back asleep.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But I don't think he has need for any of these.
Late away from the morning.
I think a potion of invulnerability would be good.
Oh, invulnerability. Yeah, shit. I forgot. Yes, yeah. That's a good one.
I definitely think Bug should have one of those.
Yeah. Well, I can carry it.
This in
it's
the
same
morning.
Size as me.
Yep.
But
you
I
need like
it.
Your own this. Shit, that's annoying.
I'm not a pixie. I can make things small. Sorry, I don't have.
Hey,
magic.
Yeah. If he takes a potion, does he need? We want him to take the whole lot so he can like use it for several uses.
Nope. No, the magic goes. Like, I had somebody explain that to me. The magic goes away once it's distributed. So the bottle would still be full, but no magic.
Right. So you can keep
it's
drinking
cool
it.
Liquid.
But
yeah.
It's like a fizzy drink.
Potions aren't
it goes
tasty.
Stale.
Yeah, it's just a not very tasty drink.
Yeah.
After a while, it just goes flat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So American beer.
Okay, so we
no
go to
magic.
Sleep.
Anyway, my noise.
Yes, thank you, Noma. Thank you. That shit's water. Okay.
So you go back to sleep. You get your long rest.
Hang on, I need to kill myself.
Oh, right.
Yeah, I will use my last second spell of lesser restoration and cure myself.
Does that work?
Yes, I used it last time.
Let me just check. I think you did, but
this would be very awkward if it doesn't.
Constitution, you didn't do that.
Let's just all be werewolves. Let's just make a werewolf group.
That
is so cute.
The player
is would look like a cute pack of dogs.
Donut has teased multiple times that lycanthropy affects fairies a little bit different. And I'm scared.
Wait, I thought you were into fairy.
Ludo, you used remove curse.
Huh?
You used remove curse.
Oh, well then I have to wait.
Yeah, then you have to wait till morning.
Okay. I will spend a sick night again.
Yeah.
But let's say I used it just in the hopes that it worked.
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to make a roll for that. You just do your morning prayer, burn a level 3 spell slot.
Oh shit, it's a level 3 spell slot.
Yep.
Should I not prepare a weapon fighting?
Yeah, I think you can. What else do you have?
I have Speak with Dead and Spirit Guardians.
Oh, these two are very good. Yeah, I'd say give up the revivify.
How long does a curse need to be there until it's permanent?
It takes effect with the first full moon.
Okay, when's the full moon now?
Let me just check something. Humanoid can affect after being wounded. you can use remove curse at any time.
Mm-hmm.
And time to the next full moon would be make a nature check.
Oh shit! Well, this is gonna go swimmingly.
Can I join in on that? Because I'm like,
I don't think Ludo's talking about it.
Oh, okay.
That was not funny. That's an 8.
Yeah, you think you have about 2 weeks.
2 weeks? That's fine. I can hang out like this and be all strong for like a week and then take it off.
Well, I mean, isn't there like unbearable pain connected to that?
No.
Yeah, last time weren't you sweating and like getting
really
sick?
Yeah, you were sweating and
shivering. Delirious.
Yeah, that is true, but that was one night, and then I got better before I removed the curse.
Oh, okay. That's true. I mean, up to you, my friend.
Yep.
Yeah.
I have a strength of 15, you guys.
Just remember what Russell had, what Russell's problem are. So I'd be respectful of all of this.
I know, this is actually me playing instead of Ludo playing.
Yeah.
I really want to be a werewolf, guys.
Just make a werewolf character.
No. I want to wear a puppy.
Yeah, if you think Ludo's going to be a puppy, you're wrong. He's going to be a very awful mongrel.
I think you'd have
he'll
to
still like, be little, so it'll be
have
cute.
A talk with your god.
He'll be like a mastiff, like his spirit guardians.
But just like slightly bigger.
Yeah. Yeah, you will still be small.
Yeah, so a mastiff would be amazing.
So, you know, it would be totally fine if I was a wolf, because then if I'm small, they can subdue me before I transform.
Well,
and, you know, it wouldn't
it
be
doesn't
a problem.
It doesn't change the stats. You'll just be smaller in size.
You're small and fierce.
Yep.
Tiny but fierce.
Yeah.
It's gonna keep going.
Oh god! You know, I'm gonna have to do this.
You don't have to. If Ludo knows.
No, Ludo knows. He got bitten before. He doesn't like it at all.
Well,
okay. I'm gonna have to like prepare a remove curse.
Sure. Maybe that's even a good thing. Who knows?
Yeah. I don't want to get rid of Speak with Dead, because I feel like where we're going, it may be useful.
Yeah. Maybe. I think Revivify is the thing that you can let go of. Even though it's a like a last resort thing.
I mean, okay. Don't
because Spirit Guardian is just too good.
I know, it's so... It's my only AoE spell, man. If, like, five things yeah. are on me, I'm dead if I don't have that spell.
At some point, you gotta name these Mastiffs, by the way.
I will name them soon, when I can think of something. Okay, so I'm getting rid of Revivify. Y'all on your own, guys. And I'll put on...
I mean, you still have other healing, right?
Yes, but Revivify
is just but no a lost resort. Oh shit, you're dead.
Yep.
Well, if you die, then too bad. Think of another character.
Wow. Yes.
Or wait until we find a temple or some shit. I don't know.
Hey, good luck with that.
Revivify is just for the first minute?
Yep.
Yes, it's just for 1 minute.
And so that's why it doesn't require any ritual rolls, because...
Yeah.
Well, in my rule set... the soul is just sort of kind of lingering, and you just
yeah.
Revivify basically just pushes it back.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay, so I have prepared remove curse, and I assume the first thing I do when I get up in the morning is remove that werewolf shit from my body.
Yeah, you feel that kind of burning hot sensation leaving your body again.
Feeling hot.
Wait, could you technically remove what? The curse from? Russell?
Nope. That's different.
Oh.
I remove the curse from other powers?
There, that depends.
Oh, if they're like, born with it.
If I had,
yeah. In a fight?
Hypothetically speaking, if I touched the leader, if
they were bitten and churned, you could. If they were born with it, you could not.
Yeah.
Then you would have to use a level 9 wish spell.
Oh, I don't care about them that much.
They can fuck their lives up, I don't care.
Yeah.
But, yeah, because I don't know them, why should I care?
Yeah.
But with a werewolf that was bitten and turned, remove curse actually works.
I
don't think the Bloodhunter class can transfer the lycanthropy. That's a whole different thing.
That would be kind of cool though. Okay. Russell made us all like that.
I'd like to object.
But not Roth, because he's already OP as shit. We do not need him to get any more OP. He's done ridiculous amounts of damage, okay? Ridiculous amounts.
Yes,
that's true.
It's
he has also caused ridiculous amounts of problems.
Yes, but it's extremely frustrating to watch an NPC do more damage than the party.
I don't think so.
I don't know, I get irritated.
Hey, but you can kill things at 120 feet. He can't.
Yeah, that's
look, I tried true. To take him out. Somebody stop me.
Yes, like all of us.
Well, technically,
well,
no.
I think
I mean,
that's been a long rest.
Let's say that if you try to take him out, both be dead.
Oh no, it's the next morning, right? Because Ludo used remove curse.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, if it's next morning, are we going to talk about the hall and who wants what?
Sure.
Because yeah. Honestly.
How long, Donut, would making just a very basic poison, how long would that take?
Have you gathered ingredients lately?
No, but I think I have some herbs that I don't know what they do. They look like they have potential.
Yes, right. Well,
I could try those.
But with trying and then making, you would need about 4 hours, I'd say.
4 hours? Shit, we don't have 4 hours. I will fly over to Sharn and maybe she can help me see what they do.
Yeah, Sharn, yeah, make an nature
check.
Yeah,
can help you later on.
I have these weird leaves. I have no idea what they do.
Ooh, that's 26.
Ooh.
Just as a description you gave me, if I remember, I think some of them are green leaves that have like jagged ends.
Yeah.
And the other ones are red berries.
Right. Red berries.
And I know that the red berries are poisonous to eat. That
yes.
That I found out. More, I didn't. I don't know what
did
they do.
Did you eat one?
No.
Yeah.
I looked at them and was like, no blueberries, no eating.
Yeah, okay. Mixed together, they would make a fairly potent poison.
Puck, why do you have poisonous berries and leaves?
It's kind of my thing. I do make poison.
Yeah. Are you going to share said poison when you make it? These are cool. Can I keep...
I gave you poison. I gave you like the most lethal one I have.
I know, but you can never have enough poison.
That's right, and I need them. Because I don't have more poison. So
I'm just asking if you're going to share this once you've made it.
I mean, it's going to be barely enough for me, but you can have some, sure.
Well, next time you find some berries like this, let me know, and I'll help you pick them.
Sure. Yep.
Okay, a hand up.
Also, just so you know, these berries cannot be used in the recipe I gave you. Just saying. You will fuck everything up if you use them.
Did you?
Good to know.
Were those the hope berries that are used to make healing potions? Maybe.
Would I know?
The recipe I gave.
No. The red berries. Oh. They probably are. No, those are. Never mind. Those are.
No. Yeah. The red berries are more like from very small.
Right.
Red.
Right.
Yeah.
And the hope berries are purple. I just remembered.
Yeah.
So I think that Io, you should have this vial of etherealness. Is everyone in agreement on that, or are we?
Donna, just one really small thing.
Yeah.
Could I, like, after the battle had finished, I just really wanted to check what Roth's expression was that I, like, stole his skills. I just want to know.
Yeah, he doesn't care.
Okay, fine. Cool. I am.
He did enough in that battle to not feel bad.
Okay, cool. Good to know. I'm just gonna come back in 5 minutes.
Okay, so I've got the one of etherealness. Bug can't carry an invulnerability one.
Invulnerability? It sounds awesome. What does it do? Can I have it?
Well, can you carry it?
I cannot carry it? No.
Doesn't he have like a...
I could probably carry it like a backpack, but on the front, but that's all.
Don't you have a vial or something like that that's empty for your poison that we could,
Yeah, put it
in. Yeah, I have empty poison vials, yeah.
So we
some of them I have
for you,
my throw and shatter, but I have one or two.
Would that work?
Consider what we just talked about, no, because you would open the...
Yeah, open the... Why don't I just hold on to it and I'll put Bug's name on it.
Sure.
I can
put
it in my bag since he's always in my bag. And
yeah, he's always around you.
Yeah.
So.
It holds for an hour, right? So if anything happens or we go in... somewhere where we know that shit's gonna go down, we can use that.
I'm just saying, also, if I have one and you have one, then depending, because there's two of them,
we're covered.
Yeah.
Then whoever he's closest to can grab from. Okay, so you have two potions, and I have the Fire Giant's strength and the invulnerability in my pouch. Does anyone want the Fire Giant's strength one? Or am I
think
just
that's
that
for Russell. Unless he already has 25.
Russell,
I mean, I don't mind being tough either. I mean, imagine a bear with fire giant strength.
Yeah, I mean...
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
Well, that doesn't work.
No,
unless you drink it as a bear.
Oh, yeah, because you take the
you take on the physical
of the
stats of the animal
you
turn into.
Yeah, not the bear. That's true.
Well, the
okay,
25
well
strength Sharn is still pretty scary.
Yeah.
Then... I still think that it would be better for Russell. if that's the case.
Well, what's your strength score, Russell? Is it like 20 already? I mean, it's not 25, I bet, obviously. Okay, so 25 would do crazy
same strength as me.
Oh, shit. But I think Russell could use him more. Because you use your wisdom.
He's more attack-based. So, do you want to hold on to it, or do you want me to have it in the bag of holding, Russell?
I think he should have it.
Yeah, I'm just checking.
Doesn't Russell still have a fire potion or fire lantern bullseye thing from ages ago?
Fire breathing?
A bullseye lantern?
Potato tends to get a couple of things. That's why I'm saying, did you want me to hold on to it? I'm just saying it isn't.
When we were in the dungeony thing.
Yeah, I'm just saying it's not.
I think she has a fire resistance.
No. Bullseye lantern. And it was a. The alchemist fire flask.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I've got the alchemist's fire.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's the only reason I'm saying. Did you want me to maybe hold on to it to give to Russell?
Or do you want to make a sticky note?
This is like an out of character, like. Like, let cat remind potato. Yeah. Okay, you're going to write it down? Okay, then I'll give it to you. Remember potato. Okay, so Russell has that. Io has that. And Io has one of those. Cool. Oh, and we have so much money, guys.
We have so much money.
Oh, yeah. We have nowhere to spend it.
We have so much money and nowhere to spend
1,000.
And we're going to die here, so we can't even use it.
200 electrum pieces.
That's right.
So, like, money-wise, we in the bike.
All right, let's get going. Okay. We need to get to this abbey.
You want to go to Krezk, right?
Yep, that's the plan.
That was the plan.
So you do make your way to Krezk the rest of the day. Weather sucks again.
I'm looking out for more of these berries and leaves.
There's constant rain, not as heavy, but it's raining.
I thought it cleared up. But I predicted it would clear up.
Maybe later today.
Well, it did clear up. It's not raining as hard anymore.
Weather prediction skills are great, guys.
You got to take this in stages. You know, there's heavy rain, there's light rain.
Yep. See, I don't have that in Australia. It's just it rains or it doesn't.
the really fun starts is when the rain is going horizontal.
Yes.
Yeah, no, we don't have that.
That's a thing.
What is that? That's not real.
It is real.
Very real.
Well, it's not exactly horizontal. It's like
almost,
just at the
slight
angle.
Yeah.
Hail also doesn't happen here.
Hail is, on one hand, very cool, and on the other hand, it hurts your head.
It does.
It's literally rain or not rain. Or really, really hot.
You have to come to Europe.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I don't want to.
Experience the world in its full capacity.
I'm going to be so cold.
Yes, probably.
It's 37 at the moment.
I mean, you can come here in summer, then it's fine.
Well.
Wait, did you say it's 37 degrees? Like, it's fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, that's what it is right now.
That's a microwave. Get out of there.
Yep, I'm dead. I'm dead.
Till make a survival check.
Alright. That's cocked, because I rolled it on the sofa. Not great at all. Survival wisdom. 5! I rolled a 2.
Yeah, it's too wet. You have to concentrate on flying, you don't find any interesting plants.
Shit.
Sorry.
Don't apologize, I made the bad roll.
And you need one of those, and you. What do we have here? As you're on your way, I'd like you all to make a perception check.
Perception.
Sorry.
19.
Natural 20. 20.
Shoot you.
23.
Okay. You all, as you are on your way, you all... What did you get? 19... 15...
Oh, sorry, I'll...
Okay. Oh, we don't need that book right now.
Thank you for yelling that.
Yeah. That has to be yelled.
Yeah.
Okay, what do you have in 20? Okay, Io and Sharn. Somebody. Oh, Ludo is still. Ludo's foraging for food, right?
Literally.
Looking out for food.
Yeah. Okay. So in that case, let me just say that Roth, Io, and Sharn notice movement in the woods to the side.
Ah, oh, fuck.
And with that, we'll take a short break because I have to make new coffee.
Oh, I'm gonna
that's a good idea. That's a good idea.
Up.
We all leave just as Aria turns up.
We're taking a short break. Ludo is foraging for food.
That'll never go well, but okay.
No, you were getting food, so.
Oh, yes, I was actually foraging.
Yeah.
What happened in this time?
If you roll for perception, you'll soon find out.
Yeah, we divvied up potions and then we went on to Krezk and now we're making perception checks.
Inside Krezk?
Nope. On the way.
No,
there.
We're on our way.
Yeah, and on the side of the road in the woods there's something.
It's never gonna end well.
Yeah.
Not 20 for cat, nice.
Yeah.
That's not very good.
What's crack-a-lackin'?
Crack-a-lackin'.
You won't have seen it. Yeah, no, you won't have seen it. If Tylmirk didn't see it with a 19, you won't have seen it.
No, I couldn't. I could see with a 19, but I couldn't see. I couldn't get the herbs. My survival check was shit.
Oh, right.
Because of the rain. Black sport, guys.
Yay!
Oh,
good call. You're eating my brother.
Super loud.
I'm just going to mute while I eat, though, because I'm respectful. No.
See, this is what I feel like when any one of you eats an Oreo. It's disgusting.
How I can finally identify with you.
Yeah. You feel so offended. Like, how dare you? Those
yeah.
things are not
and also,
on the menu.
This is like a double offense because potato also gets eaten currently
That's
with
true.
The chips. Because there's potato chips.
Yes. What is our conversation? If I cut out every single food item that we are named of after here, I would be one miserable person. No donuts, no chips, no cake.
No cake? Oh, that's not good.
No Kit Kats? No potatoes?
Yeah.
I'm already cut out Oreo. I can't eat myself. That's weird.
I would die without potato.
Oh.
Would actually just kill myself if I wasn't allowed to eat potato anymore.
Okay.
I love potato.
I mean,
so
I guess potatoes are cool.
Such love. No, literally, my family's like motto is you can't cook too many potatoes.
Oh.
Well, I
we
mean...
Eat. No, you can't.
There
it's impossible. No, not in this family.
For me, there's I mean, I guess there's a potato limit at some point.
The limit does not exist.
No potato limit. Potato unlimited.
The next movie that's coming.
Also, the second saying is salt makes potatoes taste bad if you don't put it on. No joke.
Oh, no. Well, I mean, that's true. Potatoes are not good if you don't put salt on it.
Yep. So, salt makes potatoes taste bad if you don't put it on. Family motto.
I like that. That's great.
Enjoy your potatoes tonight. I have leftover potatoes. Potatoes.
Potatoes.
Potato.
I'm gonna go and get some coffee.
I love that song, though I don't know it.
So what are we doing? We're going to Krezk and we're going to go to the Abbey and we're going to fuck shit up?
Yes. We are going to get that goddamn sword. We have been talking about it since the last 10 episodes. I think it's time we finally get it. Which he probably wants this session anyways, but you know. We have to try. I hope it's a sword that Russell can use. Like, it's not, it shouldn't be silver. Because that would kind of suck. Sword and no one can use it.
He can hold it in his metal arm.
Does that work?
Totally.
Like, I genuinely don't know how Russell's metal arm works. Does it work with, like, do the fingers bend and shit? Can he swing it? I don't know. It's like, is it magic?
It's just like...
Yeah, I mean, like, you could just take it off and hit people with it.
Oh, wank.
I don't know. Is it like... Oh, wow. Okay. But Strahd is not a werewolf, so it doesn't need to be silver. Bet it does radiant damage, though.
Mm.
Vampires are affected by silver? Wait, are they?
I prepared daylight today.
Oh, good idea.
Did you do that as well? Or should we sit down and have a spells powwow?
Did we not do this as a strategy chat?
Oh, did I not? I think I prepared mostly radiant stuff, but
good, because that's what I asked.
Yeah,
I haven't prepared much. I haven't prepared much. I have been in a mess all day, so.
So I got daylight and moonbeam.
Okay.
Moonbeam is radiant, mm-hmm. but I don't have any other radiant shit. I have fire stuff though, so I got flaming sphere.
Okay. I have like sacred flame, I have guiding bolt, I have spiritual weapon.
You're gonna have more radiant shit than me. Obviously.
Yeah.
But I got heat metal as well in case like we wanna heat shit up.
Heat shit up. What?
But like if they're holding weapons, you can just like heat metal and they'll drop them.
Yeah.
Oh,
yep. Cold meal. We could have a hot food. It'd be great.
Yeah. No, we could, like...
Oh, that's not what you mean? Oh, sorry.
Melt a metal door or something. I don't know.
No, she means that it's going to get heated.
Gonna get hot.
Yeah. Gonna get
hot in here.
We're already hot, guys. Come on.
I am actually really hot in here. Like, the aircon died.
actually, it's fairly cold here. I'm
wish it was cold.
A little bit.
Yeah, me too.
What?
My fan
is
off and on. It's okay. Like unfair weather right now.
So you see movement in the woods.
Can I go and try and hide? I'll tell the others, and I'll just like motion to the others and point the direction the sounds. But yeah, I'd like just stealth
with. A nat 20, can I see anything else, like any numbers of people or figures or it's, anything
it's
like...
People, it's, once again, it's wolves.
Oh, God.
Okay.
I hear wolves.
If it's wolves, I'm going to wild shape into a dire wolf and just howl. Like, this is my territory, back the fuck up.
Okay, make an intimidation check.
I'm not good at that.
I like how we're all just strolling along, and then suddenly, bam! Cat's a direwolf.
Yeah.
I mean, Sharn, sorry.
And I've disappeared.
12!
And you have disappeared, yes. Oh shit, I'm gonna stealth as well. I have to change to Tylmirk now.
Yeah.
If you know.
It's about time.
Yeah, you howl.
I rolled a 19. Is that not enough?
Nope.
From the perception?
Nope.
Oh shit, okay, never mind then.
You howl.
I'm concentrating or not.
All you get in back in reply is another howl that makes it clear that they don't accept your claim.
Oh, okay, then I'm gonna fuck these bitches up.
I am so bored of fighting wolves, guys.
Yeah.
I'm gonna
populated this freaking area of wolves, okay? There should not be any more.
Okay, so now we roll initiative.
Aww, you're never gonna get to the temple.
I was hoping the howl of a dire wolf would have been like, oh, fuck.
I'm rolling.
Regular yeah, wolves. But they rolled pretty good on their wisdom, so.
Everybody rolls initiative or just the ones?
Everybody, yeah.
I mean, they howled. So.
I pointed to you guys when I...
Yeah.
Before I disappeared.
So we'll just skip the surprise round.
Sorry. I just spilled my drink everywhere.
Sorry, I didn't mean to giggle at that, but...
It's got a really good hit on it, and it just spilled everywhere.
Phrasing.
Okay,
yeah, phrasing. Blueberry beer. I'm not drinking blueberry beer for Till.
Uh-huh. Why don't you give any to me, though? So, I mean, that's kind of...
I mean...
Kat, what's your initiative?
I just rolled it in. It doesn't really...
Yeah, top of the round.
Jesus, Ludo.
Yeah, I'm off.
Wait, Ross could be worse. It could be fine.
Nope. Till. You start.
So normal wolves.
Normal wolves. Yeah.
Normal wolves. Let's fuck those bitches up.
Because
I can deal with normal wolves.
There is 13 of them.
Oh, no, I cannot deal with normal wolves. I'm gonna get the fuck out of there.
The roving random encounters.
Let's do this.
They do happen.
Are they all on the right side?
Yeah.
I will fly a bit up, so I'm at tree height.
Right.
And I will, I don't know, I'll throw some rocks at them.
Okay.
Two attacks.
Right.
To the most weak-looking ones.
Well.
Like the ones on the bottom of their ladder.
The fatter, slower ones.
Yeah. My coffee's cooking, but I rolled a 24 and a 23.
They both hit.
Both, yeah. I'm gonna get my dice. That's 2d4. Twelve points of damage in total to that one wolf.
That one wolf is dead.
I wanna throw each stone into his eye.
Yeah.
In each of his eyes.
And with that, he just falls over.
And then I'm keeping up there.
Okay. Iyohe, your turn.
I am hiding behind a tree. I am going to attack with my short bow.
Yep.
Am I? That's okay, hopefully. Ooh! Plus 23.
That hits.
Yay, sneak attack! 10, 19, 20, 21, plus 25 points of damage.
Yeah, you kill another wolf with a well-placed arrow.
Nice! And as a bonus action, I'm gonna hide.
Nice.
With a 23.
Okay, you are hidden again. Sharn.
I'm gonna run up to whatever one's closest.
Yeah.
And as my bonus action, I'm gonna animal rage. And right. I'm gonna bite.
Yeah.
It. So I have advantage. Like 24 to hit.
Yeah.
So I do 12 points of damage.
Okay. So as Dire Wolf Sharn runs up to one of the wolves, she lets out a throat-ripping roar you haven't heard before. And it almost seems like that wolf, that dire wolf, gets even bigger, and then she just bites down on the neck of one of the normal wolves and just snaps it.
Yeah. I don't say because I'm hiding.
I'm gonna back up a little bit from Sean.
Okay, Russell.
You're gonna hit it with your sword.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, kill it with your sword. That's a Russell thing.
Kill it. Kill it.
It's, you're gonna run away? Why would you do that, Tedo?
So Russell draws his sword, walks up to one of the wolves, swings down, hits it. And that one actually is still alive, but barely. There's a yowl, and then it stands on its legs, but barely. Which brings us to Roth, who will just go up to that same wolf and finish it off, probably. Yeah.
Russell, Roth is stealing your kill. Just want you to know.
I'm just doing that to keep the initiative a bit tidier. So you guys are gone.
Russell's on our side now.
With
an
easy swing of his sword, he just decapitates that wolf.
Dang.
Yeah.
Why is Sharn so a large
ripped
wolf?
Yeah.
Okay.
You don't know.
Wolf's turn.
We don't know.
Okay, let's do one attack on each of you except. Well, no, we can't do that because Till is flying up and Iyohe is hidden.
Yep.
Okay, so each gets one attack plus. How many potential targets do we have? Four. Two on Sharn and two on Roth. Okay. Let's start with Roth. Attack one. Tries to bite him and misses. Second one. Misses two. With advantage. I'm amazed. Okay, one attacks Ludo. With a 22.
Yeah.
Wow. 4 points of piercing damage. Four. I'd like you to make a strength saving throw.
That's gonna really be great. Tight.
Tight. Tight.
Tight.
What was it? What did you roll? Okay, so you are now knocked prone.
Yes.
As it bites you, okay. It jumps on your onto your shoulders, and you just fall over. Next wolves will attack two attacks on Sharn.
Yep.
First one is a natural 20.
Okay.
I guess that hits. I need
so it's the games again.
I need you to make a strength save.
I don't think I'll make that. What is it?
You have advantage on those.
Yeah, I know. I got 11.
That's just enough.
Oh, cool.
But you do take 13 points of piercing damage.
Is that then halved?
Yes, it is. So 6.
Okay. 6.
And the second wolf attacks and misses. With advantage, rolled a 4 and a 1.
Oh.
And one attack on Russell. That's an 11. I think that misses. Okay, Ludo. You are now currently prone with a wolf over you.
Yeah. Okay. Can I get up first, or do I need to take care of the wolf?
You can get up with while spending half your movement.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
I'll get up and I'll cast Sacred Flame on the wolf.
Okay. Oh, he has to make a dex save, right?
Yeah.
14.
Spell save DC is 15, so he doesn't make it. That is 11 points of radiant damage.
And you burn the wolf to death.
Yay.
Nice.
Yeah. Wait, but these are... Okay, these are normal wolves.
Yeah, these are normal wolves. And now more wolves. Each...
more wolves?
Yeah. One attack each on those that can be attacked. First one goes for Roth. That's a hit. Biting him for 6 points of damage. Strength save. Yeah, that's fine. One attack on Ludo. Does a 13 hit you?
No, it does not.
Okay. One attack on Sharn. Yeah. I don't think an 11 hits the dire wolf.
Nope.
Okay. And one attack on Russell, which is a natural 20. We know that hits. That's
we know that.
That's 16 points of piercing damage, and I need a strength save from him.
Is it bad that I'm imagining the Critical Role like songs in my head, like that dun 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 dun?
No, that's fine.
It's not bad at all. Why would that be bad?
Okay, the wolf. The wolf tries to knock you over, Russell, but you are too strong. You remain standing. Okay, Till.
Yeah. Okay, I'm just gonna attack the ones that are attacking my friends. So there are 2 or 3? Or did everything get cleared up?
There is a total of 8 wolves currently attacking your friends.
Yes, I mean, alright. Okay, in that case, I will fly behind their lines.
Yeah.
Over top, and just clean up from behind.
Okay.
The one that's most in the back will get 4 full attacks. I'm gonna go one after the other because they're wolves.
Yeah.
So I can move on to the next one. Um, 21.
That hits.
For the first hit. Oh shit. That's 8 points of damage.
Okay, that wolf is still standing.
Okay, second attack.
Let's go with that batch, yeah.
11?
11 misses.
Shit. Third attack. 19?
That hits.
6 points of damage.
And you kill a wolf.
Yeah! I'm gonna break his neck. And then the next one.
Yeah.
Last attack. That's a 10.
That misses.
Okay. Well, one wolf down.
Yeah, one wolf down.
And am I in melee with anyone? With any wolf?
Currently not.
I just attacked one.
Well, that. You, oh, yeah. Yeah, right.
I just attacked one. So I will. Nah, fuck it. I'm gonna stay there.
Okay. Aya.
I'm gonna do the same thing. Yeah, attack with my whatever one's closest to me.
Right. Go ahead.
Wow. That is I can't count. 25.
That hits.
I'm liking my dice. Oh, that was shit. 5, 9, 12 points. 13 points of piercing. No. Yeah, 13 points of piercing damage.
That is enough. Another wolf down.
Beautiful. Well, and I'm going to hide again.
Yep.
Was it 28?
Alright, I think you're hidden. Sharn.
I'm going after another wolf.
Yeah, I thought so.
We just killed like a dozen wolves in 12 seconds.
Yeah.
We are monsters. These are just animals, guys. Awesome.
21.
Hits.
They started it.
They started. They are animals.
They started it.
They have an agenda.
Technically, didn't attack us. 14.
Okay, you bite. You break the neck of another wolf.
That is.
And toss it into like a pile of dead wolves.
Yeah, yeah, they are piling up.
We just walk through the forest, and everywhere we go, there's like a bunch of dead wolf bodies left behind.
Yeah, but I mean, it's an infestation here.
Do you have more than one attack?
Like,
not for the dire wolves, but can I, as a bonus action, like growl at the rest of the group? Like,
yeah, make another intimidation check.
You go and get it. 13. I'm really not that intimidating for a giant wolf.
Nope, you aren't.
You're learning.
Russell.
Like, with the pile of bodies, they're still like, nah, we can do this. We can take them.
Can you imagine how cute it would be, though? Like, and it's stupid.
That hits. Okay, so Russell, this time you swing your sword and kill one of the wolves right away.
Yay!
Drops down. Okay, Roth will attack one of the... Oh, hold on. That's those. Roth will attack the wolf that is attacking him. Oh, that hits. Rolled a 19, that should be enough. And that's 15 points of damage, that kills the wolf.
Yeah. Russell, you have two attacks. You have... You're level 6, you should definitely be...
He does not.
Attacks. Extra attack?
Nope.
No, he's not a fighter.
And he's multi-classed.
Oh. What have you multi-classed into?
He was always multi-classed, so since you met him.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
What?
He started out as a barbarian.
What?
Then he went
fuck! Then did not know that.
He raged.
You never knew he could rage!
And then he became a paladin, so...
Roth!
Oh,
Russell.
God.
I got
confused.
I was...
I know about Roth. I was
like, 4? What's the penalty?
It's early. Stop it.
No, that's fine. No, you're good.
You're good. You're good.
Yes. Russell has 2 attacks.
Yeah. All martial classes usually have 2 attacks.
Yeah.
Seriously, right there across the top of your sheet is the best thing ever. Just 2
okay,
attacks.
Russell, you can make another attack.
Yes. Please do it so that I don't have to suffer any more damage from
I have written extra attack.
Written down the bottom of mine, like in huge writing, disengage. Hide.
Where is it? There it is. Extra attack.
Oh, okay. You killed another wolf. That one's gone. Okay. So Russell, remembering what he can do, starts cleaning up.
Good job. Yeah,
Russell. Oh yeah, shit! I'm good at fighting. Hold up.
Okay,
hold my beer.
Roth is
hold my beer.
Ludo.
Hold my beer.
Don't the wolves go before me?
Not anymore. That batch of wolves is already gone.
Oh, okay, cool.
There's
2
wolves left.
I'm just gonna sacred flame.
And one is chewing on you, so.
I killed that one.
Chewing
well, it's tried to bite you, but
right, yes.
Tasty.
I will sacred flame that one, please.
Okay.
Sacred flame that fucker.
11 on the deck save. So.
No, it doesn't make it.
Nope.
That's just 5 taken.
Yeah, you singe it, but it's still alive.
I will.
It's
okay. It's a warning.
Okay, now it's the last 2 wolves' turn. One is going to attack Ludo.
Yeah. Come at me, bro.
It's cocked.
Bruh.
Come up, bro.
That's a 10, I guess that doesn't hit.
Nope.
And one is trying to attack the dire wolf. That's an 11.
Nope.
Okay, Till.
I will attack the most damaged one.
Yeah.
First, with good punch in the butt. 19.
Hits.
It's just flavor for us.
8 points of damage.
That's enough.
Yeah. And last one.
Yep.
I'll kill it.
17.
Hits.
Ooh, fuck yeah, 10 points of damage.
Okay, that one's barely alive.
Finish it up. No, he isn't. I'm gonna attack again.
Okay.
Yeah, no, it's alright.
Not this time. 18.
Hits.
Another 10 points of damage.
That's enough. He had 1 left.
Yeah. Damn it!
Nice. Okay.
Guys, we just killed an entire pack of wolves in 18 and a half seconds.
Yep.
We should call you Tylmirk Wolf Slayer, because you're really good at taking out wolves.
Yeah, I'm really good at taking out targets with low health.
Yeah. But Wolf Slayer sounds like a title.
Wolf Slayer?
Yes.
That sounds really dope, especially for a sprite.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll take that. Thank you.
You need one of the tooths around your neck or something.
No.
About as big as your neck.
Those are heavy, and they will impact my fight.
Can I go and recover some of my arrows? There's 2 down if
you
like.
You shot
4.
How many did you shoot? 2, right?
2.
So you can recover
back.
1.
4.
I just spilled coffee on me.
R.I.P. your coffee.
Does anyone want to do anything with these wolf bodies?
We could set them on fire.
I mean,
I could just do a well-timed firebolt for shits and giggles.
So like a pyre for them?
I say release them.
I mean, it gives a good distraction.
I mean, I just want the wolves in this place to realize that they shouldn't be trying to attack travelers on the road. So,
I mean, it could be good distraction as well.
Well, I'm not sure. This is just... I mean, I'm not sure, guys, but I think the wolves here are very aggressive. Are they not? Because in the woods back home, we had wolves as well, but they would always mind their business and we would mind our business.
Maybe they're
wolves are pretty cool.
These are very aggressive. They always hang around roads and stuff.
Can I check to see if the wolves have, like, I don't know, madness, rabidity? Rabidity? That's not a word. What's a thing that's called, like...
Rabies, you mean?
Like, whatever makes them froth and be mad.
They aren't. They didn't seem to be...
They just, like,
mad.
Do they seem, like...
under the breed of...
Do they seem skinny and
not really.
Okay, so they're healthy.
Yeah.
So they're getting food to eat.
I think they are just very aggressive. I think the land may be part of this.
Well, look, Strahd's always hanging out with wolves. They're probably his puppies.
That could be.
Yeah, his.
I like Russell just being like,
they're wolves.
Acting like wolves.
No, if they would be acting like wolves, they would like flee after half of them were wiped out.
Yeah.
Yeah, the alpha would attack and then it would be fine.
Wolves be loyal, bro.
Not if all of them are dead.
I mean, but they're not stupid. They're not going to just fight to the death for the sake of fighting to the death.
Yeah. I'm still in I'm not really talking.
We should just carry on before Morton up, guys.
Moving on. I just think it's weird. Wanted to say that.
Okay, let's just pile them all up and Io can shoot off a fireball and just like let the burning stench of wolf meat like drive away others. Maybe.
That would be 18.
Yeah, that's fine.
To hit with a fireball.
So you ignite the pyre, which burns a little bit, but it's still raining, so...
Of course it's raining.
Oh, shit! Wait, it's still raining? I thought the rainy day was before.
No, it was it's light rain today, not heavy rain.
Okay. Good up.
I think you missed it, but yeah.
Yeah.
But it does.
Alright, let's carry on.
Around midday, the rain actually stops.
Oh, hey, Sharn, you predicted right.
I'm a wolf. A wolf right now.
I give the wolf a thumbs up. A tiny little thumbs up.
Okay.
I'm going to stay in wolf direwolf form while we travel on the road so that if that happens again, I can maybe intimidate them again or at least my scent or, I don't know, something.
Are you marking your territory all the way there?
Hells yeah.
Okay.
Hells yeah.
Just check.
Okay. So as you cross the bridge over the Raven River...
was called the Raven River.
You come to a... there is a creature coming up towards you across the road.
Perception check!
Yeah. Mm.
Can I have time to stealth and hide?
Make a perception check first.
Nat 20! On perception.
Okay. You and your fucking perception. Crazy. I haven't met.
I enroll it. What's the difference?
I have a 16. No, that's cool as well.
Best thing in the world.
I mean, it's alright. Yeah, it's no, not 20, but you know.
All these 20s, though.
Same down under. Down under.
Okay. So you see it's the body of a human male. That looks like it has been actually dead for a couple of days. But it's walking very purposefully.
Okay.
I will hide.
Right?
Yeah, can I hide?
I'm gonna growl at that shit.
Yeah.
This is, oh shit. Can we recognize the person?
You have never seen that person before.
Never roll backwards, guys.
I will not hide.
I'm not hiding.
And speak with this person.
I'm getting...
Math. 16. 16 stealth.
Y'all stealthing?
Nope.
No, I'm just gonna hide. I think me and...
Me and Io, I think.
Okay.
Yeah. Io and
I would like some direwolf backup if...
Yeah, no, I'm there. I'm growling. I'm...
Wolf backup.
Yeah. Cool.
I think nobody's hiding except us two, right?
Yeah. Which direction is the body moving in?
So it's coming from the direction roughly of Krezk. So it's coming your way.
Oh boy.
Are we about...
I like how Io and I just...
You are somewhere around here.
Yeah.
And it's coming from...
Yeah, we just disappear.
That
yeah. Ooh, someone's coming.
Oh,
nope,
fuck this. We're out.
Fuck this. Nope.
Are they looking at all aggressively as they see
us? Yeah, pretty much.
They're looking aggressive.
It's, yeah, the creature is striding directly towards you.
Aww.
Looking very purposefully.
How close is it?
It's about 80 feet away right now.
When it gets within, I'm going to say 50 feet, I'm going to drop form and cast hold person.
Okay.
Ooh.
Right. It just keeps moving towards you. Let's roll initiative first, because 60 feet would be the interesting... range.
Would I have the possibility to, before that happens, fly a bit next to the road, fly up to it a bit closer and see what it is? Or would I have to do that in initiative?
You'd have to do that in initiative.
All right. I always forget my initiative.
Okay.
I am having a very bad feeling about this.
Yeah, same. That's why I was like, ooh.
Because, you know, it came from Krezk. There was such a nice place.
That place be just zombies now.
Okay, so yes, we have IO-20...
Isn't it just on the road to Krezk and it's coming from
there?
It's
coming from, on the road that leads to Krezk, basically.
Oh, so we're on the crossroads?
Yes, you just passed
that. Oh, shit. So it's clear that it's coming from Krezk and not from the old Swallow Road?
Well, it doesn't have to come from Krezk.
Well,
it could come because be coming from the road.
Because we saw some skeleton dude coming from old Swallow Road.
Yep.
So maybe that guy is from there too.
But
Ludo Sharn, what's your dex modifier?
Mine's only plus one. So you probably go first.
Okay. Ludo Sharn. And because I made a mistake earlier, I would like you to make a wisdom check. Just
check?
Not a saving throw, just a check.
That's bad.
19.
Yeah.
11. 12. Okay. Sharn, you do recognize the form. It looks like one of the druids.
What?
Yeah.
One of the druids.
No.
Yep.
Is it headless?
It is not headless, but the head kind of has a flickering...
No. Fuck no.
Nope.
I'm so good at
this. No. Let us go back to Malanki. That sword can stay where it is.
What the fuck? I just, like, after I drop my form, I'm just looking at Ludo and I'm like, the fuck?
Does everything that die in that binary not stay dead?
I don't know. It's one of the druids. And as soon as it comes into... I'm going to do the whole person thing, hopefully.
Okay. So you cast that spell, realizing who you're seeing.
Yep.
And nothing happens.
It's not a person.
It's not a person.
You burn the spell slot.
Yep.
Oh my god, it's not a person.
Bye.
Yeah, it's undead, right? It's not a person.
If this is like the tree before that showed me my own hanging body, I'm going to be so pissed off.
Ayo, it's your turn.
We'll see it though, right?
Oh my god. I am going to... Yeah, I'm going to have my longbow out with my arrow, readying an action until it attacks one of my friends.
Okay.
Please.
Oh boy. Ludo.
Okay. I don't know what to do, because... I mean, I kind of know what to do, but I need it to be, like, dead, or, like...
Do you have, like, this...
I don't want to blow this, okay?
I love this so much.
We can always rest at the town before we go into the abbey.
Yes, no, I know that. But, like, I don't want it to run away either. Which is what I can make it do.
Oh, that's true.
Okay, I am going to hold my action. And if it is at all aggressive to me, I will do a guiding bolt at it.
Right. Okay.
And that'll be my turn.
So we would be back to Sharn.
Would I, having the spell take no effect, can I do like a, I don't know, like a do I recognize that it doesn't take effect? Do I?
Yes. Yes.
Like. Can I make a perception to see if it's maybe an illusion?
Make a perception check.
I don't know. I don't know. Like, at this point, Sharn thinks it might not be real now. Perception. Ooh, where is it? That's 20, not natural.
Yeah, it looks fairly... the body looks solid. It's just the face that is kind of...
The face.
The head is kind of... looks bit ethereal.
Okay. Was that my action or a bonus? Or
that's
like...
a bonus.
Okay. Can I throw a spear into it?
Sure.
To just see if it'll like
go ahead.
Hit? Well, that's not going to hit.
I love playing these battles.
That's a 6.
Yeah, that's... Beer goes wide.
Oh, my aim is really off, guys.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
It's freaking me out.
Oh, wait, is this the spear which comes back? What? There was a spear.
No, this
it
is the spear,
like spear that came back.
That one only comes back when she goes and gets it.
Oh. I must have missed
it. Rather than a boomerang?
Okay, Till.
How far away is he?
50 feet.
Okay. I mean, I can go there. I'm not sure if I want to. I'd like to fly closer and just see, not the whole 50 feet, but like 30 feet.
Okay.
And just see if it's a real body or if it's not a real body.
Yeah, okay, make a perception check.
Please don't.
Fuck! Go. 7. Fucking shit.
Yeah, you are kind of weirded out by the slightly flickering head. So you fail to notice anything.
Okay. But so the head looks, you said that before, the head looks kind of more unreal than the rest?
Yep.
Okay.
That's not the wildest theory.
How much light is there?
It's overcast. It's not raining anymore.
But it's
overcast.
It's not dim light. You wouldn't say it's dim light.
No.
Okay. Did we try attack it already?
Well,
I mean, a couple of them tried.
Sharn threw a spear.
It failed. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I will just throw a rock at it and okay. where its neck would be, not where its head would be. Oh, that's good. That's real good. That's a 25.
That hits.
Fuck. 5 points of damage.
Okay. It does hit.
Reduce.
And it does impact, but it doesn't stop it.
Okay. Does it leave a mark where it impacted?
Yep.
Does it? So I saw that it does damage.
Yeah.
Okay, second attack then. even better, that's a 26.
That also hits.
Yes, Ludo.
6 points of damage.
Okay.
And then I will fly back to my friends.
Right.
Still hidden, though.
Your friends.
Do I have to roll stealth again?
Because
I attack?
You can't. Because you are
not. Yes, I can't. That's true.
Okay.
All right, I will just fly up into the trees then.
Right. Yeah, so you make two hits and, you know, the body moves with the impact.
All right. Not an illusion, guys.
Russell. It's 50 feet away at the moment.
I'm so glad we've got a mime in our group.
Okay. Oh, wow. Russell draws his crossbow.
I always forget he has one. I always forget I have
so
one.
So is Russell.
Nope.
Okay, one bolt goes wide. You have a second
Rusty.
Attack.
I love this game so much.
That hits.
Hey.
Can it even talk without a head? That's my question.
You haven't found out yet.
Magic.
It just pulls up a sign.
Do you still have the skulls of the man and his brother?
They are in the mansion.
They're in the mansion.
On a shelf.
Oh, shit.
Yep.
Maybe he's looking for that.
So, the creature moves 30 feet up. It's now 20 feet away from you. And gives a glare towards Sharn, and there is this raspy voice, "You killed me." And I would like Sharn to make a wisdom saving throw, please.
Hell fuck yeah, we did. This is so.
I'm so good behind.
Only 10.
Okay, so these empty eyes glaring at you make your body just freeze, your muscles lock up. And you are paralyzed.
Fuck. Oh.
Fucking shit.
My god.
Could I use my held action?
Yes, you can.
Okay, so I have a roll for a guiding bolt.
Yeah, right.
Answer my previous question. Yes, you can talk about it.
That's 18. Oh, you wait, guiding bolt is an attack or?
Yeah, I have to roll.
Okay.
14 to hit.
14 to hit. That hits.
Hey.
Oh.
13 points of radiant damage.
Okay.
I'm going to use my held action now, seeing as the attack as well.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Yep.
Ooh, that is only a 13 to hit?
That hits, just hits.
Ooh, and is it sneak attack since I'm still hiding?
Yep.
Yeah. 6, 8, 9, 10, 14 piercing.
Okay. Nice. Okay, so now it's Roth's turn, who will draw a sword and walk up to it.
I feel like this is the time for that mead. Bet you thought you'd seen the last of me.
And does hit.
Why did you stay there?
Does hit. Anything special on this? Nah, not yet. 7 plus 5 is 12 points of damage. Okay. Io, it's your turn.
I'm gonna attack again. I didn't hide again, so it's just gonna be a regular one again.
You did not.
That's okay. That's a 9.
That misses.
Yeah, and then I'm gonna try and hide again.
Yep.
That's 23.
Okay. Ludo.
Cool.
I will use Sacred Flame on it.
Okay.
So can I make a dex save?
Yep. That's 15. That's enough.
That is 15. 15
yeah.
is my DC.
Yeah, so he makes the save.
Ah!
And those go wide. Okay, Sharn is paralyzed. Cannot move. Can't do anything.
We're just too creeped out to do anything.
Till.
Fuck. I'm
going to do the same thing to it, so.
It can talk.
Yep.
So that's. And it knows what it was before, okay. So that's also fine.
Yep.
I will just, because I'm not hidden anymore, right? I will just fly behind my friends.
Yep.
And just yell, "Oi! Okay. Why are you here? What are you doing? What is this?"
Wants revenge.
Okay.
I don't know. Maybe it's he's sent. Maybe by someone.
It's a bitch.
Right.
Just thought I'd ask.
Okay.
And I will. I'll not do. I'll take the dodge action.
Okay.
In case anybody attacks me.
Right, Russell, your turn. It's now, you can now reach it for me.
Yes!
Russell's gonna hit with his sword.
He'll try.
14. That hits, right?
Yep, that hits. Okay, nice. Right, second attack, 19 hits.
Don't kill it before it answers.
Ahem. You have a cleric.
Okay.
That's true, but it was already dead. I don't know how that would go.
It doesn't have a head.
Well, it's not going to answer
it. But it already talked, so...
Yeah.
Okay, so you damage it. It's starting to look rough. A bit. And it's now its turn, and it just keeps walking up towards the paralyzed Sharn.
Don't ignore me, bitch. Normally ignore me, but now.
The paralysis is gone now.
Oh, yay.
But you are now frightened for 1 minute.
Ah, fuck.
Oh. God,
what is this? Sharn doesn't know fear.
Nothing frightens
Sharn.
Oh, Sharn.
Now she does.
Yeah.
if I rage, does that go away?
I'll have to check.
I think so.
I think
you
that comes later, but...
Oh.
I don't think that's first level stuff.
Oh.
I'll check.
Nope. That comes later.
Oh, true.
Okay, so since he just walks past, Roth and Russell get to make an attack of opportunity.
Oh, hey.
That hits. Reroll that. 6 plus 5 is 11.
He's so...
It's...
determined. Maybe he should see what he wants.
He wants to kill me. That's pretty obvious.
But he didn't say that. He just said, you killed me. Maybe he wants to give you something.
And for that, you get this
Yeah.
Okay, so it walks up to Sharn, who's now not paralyzed anymore, but shaking shaking with fear. And it just... sorry. It walks up to you and just slams... tries to slam a fist into you.
Oh. Okay.
Oh. That's fair. I mean, I did kill it. I tortured this one as well.
Does a 16 hit you?
Just.
Okay.
Are you a wolf? No, right?
60?
Okay.
I thought your AC was like 13 or some shit.
Yeah, but then I became barbarian.
Yeah. Wow.
I love how, like, right, you are about that, man.
That's cool.
Fucking badass. Badass.
Sorry.
Kind of.
Like, yeah, bitch.
Okay, so drawing its fist back with a snarl. You take 29 points of bludgeoning damage as it hits you.
Fuck. That hurts.
And
that,
it's again, really hurts. You killed me. And it, as it swings a second time, it goes, I will have my revenge.
Shit.
But the second swing misses, goes wide.
Fuck yeah.
It's a double over after the first, it just swings too high. But that really hurt.
That really fucking hurt.
Yep.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh god, we're all dead.
Roth. Roth. Wait, that's me. Sorry.
Hey, Roth, your sister's getting attacked. Go do your protection shit.
Roth runs after it and attacks it. Because you're frightened, he doesn't have advantage because it's not considered flanked.
Nope.
That does hit though. And he will use... this time he will use a smite. Which I will have to look up. Because I'm out of practice. Paladin, here you go. Divine smite. 2d8. Radiant, okay. 2d8 radiant. So that's 10, 15, 18, 24.
Yes, chap, yes.
Okay, so Roth hits it with his sword from behind and leaves a big gash in its back, and there is this flash of radiant light that accompanies his hit. And he growls, leave my sister alone!
Fuck!
He is not happy. But he hasn't raged yet, for some reason. Who cares?
I was trying to be better, maybe?
I'm just gonna attack him with my shotgun.
Go ahead.
I said, oh, natural 20.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Natural 20.
Get him. Ignore me.
You got a lot of cool shit at level 6, which you haven't used even once.
It's natural 20 with sneak attack.
Who are you talking to?
That is. Okay.
Oh, Russell.
Full weapon damage, full sneak damage, and you roll these dice again and add those.
Nice.
Shit.
Get it out.
Again?
Just the normal.
Say it again.
So you take the.
Just
full
another 1d6.
And the sneak attack.
Okay.
Attack 2.
13. Okay. Ooh, that is 10 plus 6 plus 5. That's 21. 23. And then I've got to do another 1d6. Is that right? 28.
Okay. Let me just check something.
God. Confusing.
Okay, so you hit it right in the back. And it groans as you hit it. Ludo.
Oh shit, that did not take it down. Is it looking rough?
It's looking very rough.
How long is this fucker?
Okay,
good.
In which case I will Sacred Flame it again.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nope, doesn't make it safe.
Hey. That's 7 points of radiant damage.
Okay. It's... the skin is blackening.
It's not dead yet?
Nope, not quite.
I will call Spiritual Weapon. This is getting stupid now. Yes, I will call up my Spiritual Weapon and try to slice him.
Okay.
Ooh, that definitely hits. 23 or something.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yep, yep, yep.
Yeah, so 1d8, 6 plus my wisdom. That's 10 points of force damage.
Nice. Okay, Till.
God damn it, I still didn't finish it. He is strong.
I think it's just too late at this point.
Oh, sorry, I missed Sharn, but you're frightened, so...
I can still move and shit.
You can move away, yeah.
Or turn into a bear.
Frank creature has disadvantage on ability and attack rolls. Yeah, and you can't move closer. So you could attack with disadvantage.
Yeah, I could turn into a bear and attack twice. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Turn into a bear and attack twice.
Okay. So you go to your safe place, which is a bear.
Yeah.
This is a safe space. I mean, bear.
this is my happy 14. Place.
This is my happy place.
That hits, yeah.
I don't think
that. Otherwise known as bear.
Yeah, bear. I like my bear. Bearness. Let me just find my bear stats. I didn't think...
Bear that's with like her. Well, she's
like pretty bear.
Yeah. Dip, 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 dip. Where is...
That's the brown bear, right?
Yeah, sorry, I've got it now.
Plus 5 to hit.
Yep, but I hit, so 1d8 plus 4.
Yep.
In case of fright or low hit points, try
so
bear.
8 damage.
Okay, so you bite it, yeah, reluctantly.
And try again. And 16 on the second.
That hits 2.
So 2d6. Eleven on the second.
Okay, so... Sharn turns into a bear, and it looks kind of weird making roaring attacks, while at the same time it seems like the back half is moving away.
Oh god.
Okay, Russell. Your turn. Oh no, Till, sorry.
No, it's my turn. I will... just straight up attack it 4 times.
Okay.
Because we are resting afterwards in Krezk, right? I don't have to worry about key points?
Yes,
hopefully.
So 4 attacks
hopefully.
It is.
Okay.
Because don't ignore me, bitch. 17?
Hits.
Cool.
Oh my god, it's so hot. Sorry, guys.
I
was thinking it's hot.
10
yeah,
points
like
of
18.
Damage.
How much?
10.
10, okay.
These are magical, by the way, now.
Yeah. Fine.
Just in case it makes a difference. That's shit. That's 11.
That misses.
Okay. Third attack. Fuck, 10.
Misses.
And last one. Fuck. 22.
That hits.
That was a long way to go for a roll. Another 10.
Okay.
Oh no, 8, sorry. 8 this time.
Right. Okay, now it's Russell's turn.
And I'm like, don't lose your head over it.
No. Just no.
No, you did not.
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't accept that.
And I fly out of reach.
You have to play a bard at some point. You fly out of
reach. I will. Yep.
You do.
Then you get an attack of opportunity.
Yes.
Please multi-class into
a bat. Does a 20 hit you? Non-natural.
Yes, it does.
Non-natural. Okay.
Oh no.
Multiple. Oh. Okay, nice.
So
that
it's
works
just an opportunity to attack, huh?
Yeah, but that's still that just is the way it is. That's
multi attack.
What? Multiple attack?
That's 23 points of bludgeoning damage.
Oh cool. Wow, I'm almost down. Shit. 23
yeah,
you said?
Yeah. I just realized something.
I'm at 11, and I was full.
Yeah, sorry.
don't apologize.
He's pissed at you. Ruffle.
Did you realize that you have multi-attack?
So you, the 20 was to hit it, or?
Yeah.
Okay,
so
you hit it, yeah. Okay, and your second attack? That hits two. Yep. Okay. And now, as it comes to its turn, the body crumbles into dust, and the last thing you hear. As it does is, I will be back for you. And then it disappears.
Shit, can I do something?
You had it at minus 86 hit points.
We had it at minus 86 hit
points.
It was just alive out of spite.
The body is destroyed when it starts with starts its turn with 0 hit points. And another condition doesn't apply, but we don't talk about that.
Oh man, I can't cast speak with dead on like dust, can
nope.
I?
Nope, you can't. And we'll take a break here since two of us are gone and I have to get coffee.
Yeah,
and Sean can get over her fright.
Sean can get over it.
Shut up. Raptor will be like, it's okay, sister kin. There is nothing to worry about now.
Yeah, I'm back.
Oh God! What is happening?
Just so you know, I was talking to Potato earlier. She's not very good at writing shit down for her character, and she's like every 3 levels, maybe she levels her character.
I imagine that. She has some wicked cool stuff.
I know, but she was like, "Yeah, no, I haven't leveled." Yeah, but she's playing it off like Russell doesn't know what he's capable of because he doesn't really know, so she's playing it like that.
So. I just wanted her to know that, hey, you know, in case we die.
Yeah, that's why I was like, do you want me to keep the fire strength thing? I'm going to go cool off because it is so fucking hot. I'll be back in a tick.
Oh, man. Why are dead things coming after us? We have to handle this goddamn druid problem. Ah, okay, I see. So how is he going to learn? Like, is it just going to happen someday uncontrollably or something like that? totally cool. I understand. Because I was like, what? Don't like blood hunters get something at level 6? Because I have played a blood hunter before. Like, don't they get something? And I checked it and I was like, holy shit, they get something. So cool. All good.
I'm so hot.
Yeah.
Obviously.
I have a spray bottle with a fan on it, and it's keeping me cool.
That is so cool.
It's literally what's literally alive right now.
Missed it, bitch. Missed it.
Why are dead things coming after Sharn?
Because I brutally murdered the druids.
That's fine. We brutally murdered like several people in Barovia. Not everyone's coming after us.
Druids are special though. They have abilities. I don't know.
I was totally worried that it was coming for the staff. I was like, yay. Yeah. Sorry.
Maybe we need to like clear out that whole druid camp thing. Maybe like some of their people are reanimating them. I don't know.
Maybe.
This is bullshit. Can you imagine traveling around Barovia with one more threat behind our heads?
It's like a mini Hodus, but not as bad.
a revenant.
It's just like a weird thing that follows you. It's like a stalker. An aggressive stalker.
Thanks. Just what we needed.
It loves you.
It's not going after you guys. You don't have to worry about it.
I mean, yeah, we can't just leave Shad behind. It's fine.
We have to worry about it because it's coming after you.
No, we will just shove Shad in front. Roth will go even more in front because he's obsessed with protecting her. And
we go take a chill pill.
Yeah.
Kat, are you dying?
Yes.
you look like you're dying.
I was just saying, I've got this. It's like a fan and a water bottle spray in one.
Misty spray. That's the new D&D spell.
And it's keeping me alive right now because, oh my god, it's so hot. It's because the aircon's died and there's nothing right now. It's just so hot.
Yeah.
I went out of the room and it's so cold in the rest of the house and this room is just like boiling because there's no airflow in here. I'm just like, dying. Yeah.
It's In a couple hours, the doctor will come through, which is a breeze, sea breeze that comes through.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. When the doctor comes through, it'll be better, but I have to wait a couple hours.
I love that it's called the doctor.
Yeah.
That's everything I wish for.
Yep.
A lot of breezes from the coasts are called the doctors.
Yeah, the doctors.
I know in South Africa there is.
Well, I don't have an ocean. So I don't have doctors.
Oh.
Okay.
But yeah, once that comes through, we'll open the house up and it'll be nice and cool, but it's going to be another couple of hours before it comes through.
I would like all of you to make a religion check to maybe figure out what you just saw.
It's not okay. Like Ludo's going to know, but sure. That's a natural one. Wait, can I use lucky? I can use lucky.
That's I rolled character
because I rolled. I know so much religion, guys. I'm the most religious person here.
You're so religious.
So religious. Okay. The hell if Russell gets this and I don't? This is embarrassing.
Okay, so
I rolled.
So Russell is the one who knows.
This is bullshit.
Summary.
That this is.
Better find one, Donut.
That this is what is called a revenant.
Oh.
I said that in break.
And they are mortals who return to avenge their death. And they keep coming back after 24 hours.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
They
should, like, burn.
They inhabit a new body.
I've forgotten how we kill them.
How do we kill them? It's my only question.
You don't.
Do we know that?
You would need a wish spell to force the soul to go to the afterlife.
What the fuck?
Forever?
On this plane, on this plane of existence.
On this
plane.
All right, but does it inhabit the same body?
Nope. It can't find any corpse. The closest corpse.
We are not leaving any corpses behind now. We are burning them all.
Hold up. What if we take this corpse right here, the one that we have right here, and put it in a cage?
It's dust.
It turned to dust.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's find the closest corpse and put it in a cage, and when it comes back, it cannot escape.
I don't know if it will particularly choose the corpse which is in the cage, but
if
maybe.
It kills me and I die, does it go away?
Probably.
No, don't do that.
But it's...
Sharn. That's a bad idea.
But you have kind of the feeling it's all of you.
Oh, now boring. It's all of us. Great. Yeah. Well, there goes my plan.
Okay.
Yeah,
I feel less guilty.
Okay,
now.
But it's not if it's all of us,
yeah.
It's just still one Revenant, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So far.
Yeah, we know of.
Do we know if the others are also becoming Revenants?
Doesn't have to be. It's kind of a... Some souls do, some souls don't.
Oh. So it's like how vengeful the soul is.
Yeah.
I mean, let's be honest, I decapitated then after I decapitated, destroyed the body in front of it while you were speaking to dead at it. So it could see its body becoming mutilated.
Oh yeah.
I was in a bad place.
So you're going to be in a worse place now if it comes back for you.
Yeah, the only one not affected by that vow is Roth, because
God damn it, by him!
Well, he's affected by some other shit.
Let's just agree that we all have issues in this group and continue to do what we can.
Which is what now? Are we going to keep just,
can we, like, just
from this thing?
Like, take the soul out of
our back?
Can we go maybe talk to like a priest about this shit?
Well, it's coming back in 24 hours.
You didn't even know what it was.
We have 24 hours to deal with the Abbey before it comes back.
Yeah, now we're just on time. Dude, we're on a time limit now.
And then it has to find you again, so.
Yeah, and it has to find us.
It's like a walking speed, though, so we could just, like, run
away. Yeah, it didn't run, right? It's just relentless walk. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so anytime we see it...
We can't even outrun it.
Yeah, anytime we see it, we just turn direction and go the other way as fast as we can.
Yeah.
That sounds good to me.
Yeah. If we see it in time.
I mean, is there a way to put it at rest? Can we pretend to kill you? No, but it wants us all dead. Can we pretend to kill all ourselves?
I don't think so. Can we, like, take the soul out to a beer and just make
can
up?
Can you make a poison that'll kill us for, like, a short time and then bring us back?
Guys, dying is not fun. I don't want to die.
Does anybody here look like they want
to die? Yeah, I prefer not to.
It's a place I don't want to go.
It hits really hard, guys. Like, and I've looked at, like, I've got like a big bruise on my stomach. Like, it hurts.
Yeah. Until you are.
Do you need healing?
You have a full body bruise.
You know.
I'm just one living bruise at this point.
I'm right for now. If we're just heading towards thing, I'll be fine.
Do either of you need healing? Don't ask me.
Yes, I'd like some healing because I was slapped to the ground and I have scrapes all over and everything hurts.
All right. Land on my hand. I'll give you a cure wound.
Okay. I land on his hand.
Yeah.
Although I'm not.
Wait, I don't have to roll that. I'm rolling the wrong thing. Oh. I always roll one for this. 5. Healing points.
Oh, nice. 16. I'm over half again. That's good.
I'm going to healing word myself.
Okay.
I could heal you too if you needed.
No, I don't need your help.
Good.
Wow.
You can take your brother's help. He knows how to heal.
Does he though?
Yeah.
I don't see him healing anybody though. Just pointing that out.
No one's dying. Everyone's fine. Calm down, Ludo.
I mean, I'm not fine, but...
Yeah, Roth will cast a Cure Wounds as well on Sharn.
Did I get
it? Oh, me! No! Don't heal me!
That's 10 points.
Ah, fuck.
Yeah, fuck.
Get a Cure Wounds.
I don't need it, but thanks.
You're welcome. Okay, we should move on.
Yes. We walk to Krezk.
Yes, and you reach Krezk. Without any further interlude.
Like, no more revenants and shit?
Nope.
Alright. Is it still, like,
the
prettiest place in Barovia? Is it still the prettiest place in Barovia?
Yeah.
Cool!
And the guards aren't undead or ghosts or skeletons or anything like that? Cool, just checking.
Okay. They let us in, right? Because before there are issues with
animals,
they know us now.
Yeah, you are being let in.
No new leaders, you should know. Are they?
No.
We met a couple of people there, though. Hang on. The Burgomaster of Krezk is Dimitri Kreskov.
Yes, he is.
Which should make it easier for me to remember, but I still didn't. Good job, Mario.
And he greets you at the door. After you are being let in, he's informed. Hello, it is good to see you.
Hello, Dimitri. How's the town, village, Krezk?
Things are as usual.
Did you get the wine?
Yes, we did. Thank you.
I'd be dying.
That was very helpful.
Good. Always happy to help. No more disappearing bodies lately. Have there been any?
No, there has been nothing we noticed.
Well, that's good. Good. Well done. Keep it up. Could we perhaps trouble you to rest here for the night?
Because, of course you can.
We have business in this area.
Right.
General area.
Yes, you can rest at my place again if you want to.
Thank you. Are there any, like, free houses, like real estate, which maybe we could purchase? We have a shit ton of money. We could have our own house.
Yes, there is a free house.
I'm not paying
I don't want
house.
Ties here. I don't want ties to Barovia.
Yeah, I don't want to buy a house,
I want to get the fuck out of here.
Have a tent or something. We don't need a house.
Nah, we don't need a house.
Ludo, you could buy a house with your money.
We can sleep on the boat.
Which is 10 gold and 1 silver. Okay.
We can chill by that, like that little small shrine that Sean made.
Well, improved, not made.
No, we're not going anywhere near that house.
I know.
Maybe Roth would like to go there.
Maybe Roth, yeah.
Maybe, because he's not seen it. Maybe he'd like to go and say hi to his god.
Let's just chill somewhere under the trees. It's fine.
I mean, you can't sleep in the Burgomaster's house.
Fine.
You can have a long rest there.
Great, we'll do that.
And there would actually be a free house if you wanted to purchase it.
How much would it cost?
I didn't realize Ludo was that rich.
300 gold.
Well, you know, technically, I killed that werewolf leader guy, so I should be getting all the money from that. Just saying.
Do you have a bag of holding to hold all that gold in?
It's gold. I can carry it in my pocket.
Yeah, all of it? Are you sure?
I could try.
I mean, if we're going to divvy up each kill, let's be a...
Yeah, never mind.
How deep is the lake?
It's only
deep
a
enough
pool.
To go swimming?
I'm not going anywhere near that.
It's not that deep. It's just a pool of water, so it's maybe 3 feet deep.
Bugger. What time of day is it, by the way?
It's early afternoon.
Okay.
We are not doing that at night. Please.
No, I say we'll do it tomorrow. No. So we have a half time off, half a day off.
Yeah.
Let's. Why don't we ask about the Abbey, and like learn more about it while we've got time?
Didn't we do that last time?
Yeah, they said they were howling and screaming.
Abbey was named after the priest of a morning lord stood against Strahd. They stormed Castle Ravenloft and were never heard of again. Saint Markovia or Markovia, I don't know. The abbot runs the abbey now, but he looks like he hasn't aged at all. Wait, which abbot?
The abbot.
Oh, we don't know. There's just an abbot in the abbey.
Yeah. They say he's a weird guy.
Yeah,
maybe we can meet him. Maybe we can ask for an introduction or something. I don't know.
Yeah, okay, we can like find out his name and things.
Yeah, but isn't he always up in the abbey?
He is.
I think he stays there.
And the people of Krezk don't go there, I think.
No, because they
say... Yeah, and we got told to stay.
What if we got like a formal invitation from the Burgomaster to meet him? I don't know. Ideas, guys.
Recommendation.
Yeah, ideas.
Yeah.
I mean... It's a possibility.
Well, we have half a day.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
does the Burgomaster even like him?
Doesn't matter.
No, he is mainly afraid of him.
I think everybody in town doesn't like the Abbey. At least anymore.
Yeah.
Well, Till's gonna spend a good time to make some poison.
Okay.
With the ingredients he found, and I want to make sure that he learns about them and knows what they do.
Okay.
Do you want help with that?
Sure.
Make a nature check with advantage.
Nature. With advantage, that's good. I'm also bad. I rolled a 6 and a 3, and that turns to out to be nature is intelligence. Wow, I rolled in 7.
No.
Dude.
I do poison, guys.
That doesn't work.
I want to try.
I mean, you could add your proficiency, but that wouldn't help.
I mean, yeah, if I add my proficiency, it's 10.
Yeah, that doesn't help.
I'm just going to roll and see what I might have got.
Do I lose the ingredients, though?
Yep.
Fuck.
I would have gotten 14.
Yeah.
So not much better.
Not quite enough.
I go with the mush that I have now.
Yeah.
I go to some kind of... just the next best guy that looks like a former dude.
Yeah.
I'll go to him and be like, do you have something like this? These are red berries, and I don't know what they're called.
Oh, God.
Do you know how...
No, I'm sorry.
Where I can find those?
Those do not grow here.
Okay. And the leaves?
I can't believe you should.
Neither.
Can you tell me how they are called? Donut hates me.
No, he actually can.
Oh.
We call these red berries. We call them devil fruit.
Devil fruit.
Strahd's favorite dessert.
I feel like this place is not good with subtlety at all.
Really?
just saying this.
I like it.
Why be subtle about a berry that can kill you?
Yeah.
No, the whole area. Ravens, Ravens.
And the berries, berries are just poisonous enough themselves, right?
Yes. And it's these leaves look like they come from an elder birch.
Elder birch. Jagged leaves.
Yes, but they do not grow in this village.
Okay.
Because they are poisonous, I hope you know.
Yes, I know. That's the whole point. Goodbye, have a nice day.
But
Okay, that guy had a 20 on his nature roll.
Oh shit.
I mean, he grows his own stuff.
Was that guy, what's his name, Alexander?
Nah, he was just a random farmer.
Random farmer. What is it, Sharn? What's the problem?
Oh, I was just wondering if you needed any venoms, like, for your potions.
Yes. Wasp and viper venom are the best.
I could get you viper venom by being a viper.
Oh, that's true.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah. Next time you need.
Oh my god, are you about to milk Sharn?
No. I was going in that direction and then I stopped.
You saw the red light and you.
In my own time and give it to you.
I mean, yeah, Sharn, I can milk you, it's no problem.
No, Bug, you can understand.
I know. I don't know, I'm making jokes. You can give me the venom if you're a snake next time. It's cool.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Later.
Thank you.
Okay. Anything else you want to do before you rest?
I have something in the evening, but
yeah, I just want to go and check on that little graveyard area if there are any more freshly dug graves.
There are currently not.
Okay. Shucks, what do I do? Okay, then I'll just kind of wander around the place because I really like Krezk. I might go to the pool.
Okay. There's still some wine growing and it looks really pretty.
Cool. Oh, I will do a thing. I will take one silver piece and flick it into the pool.
Okay.
Just for the heck of it. I'm removing this one irritating silver piece I had. I don't know why I was thinking it. I like round numbers, I don't like odd numbers.
Okay. Yeah. So it falls into the water and roll a d20, just for the hell of it.
I don't like this, I'm going to die.
Natural 20, you get a magical wish.
I hope.
Nikki appears and is like, Ludo, 11. Why you do
and
this?
Nothing happens.
Okay, that's fine.
If nobody else has anything, I would like to find Roth.
He's sitting somewhere under a tree.
Hey, Roth. What's up?
Not much. It's nice here.
I have some questions, if you don't mind, because we never really talked outside of arguing lately.
Go ahead.
You understand that it's kind of weird for us, right? That you're here again?
Well, it's weird for me too, so.
I have just some questions to understand it a bit better. Do you, first of all, do you remember everything from before?
From before, yes. Up until I died.
Yes.
After that,
and then you don't remember?
Things are a bit blurry.
Okay.
I remember someone or someone's talking to me. And then I came back.
Okay. And please understand, I do not mean offense by any of these questions, by the way. I just try to understand more. Mm-hmm. When we first met you, you were kind of hot on the Morning Lord.
Yes.
Is he still? That's how Till talks. Is he still with you, or?
I don't think so. Nope.
Because, I mean, Sharn knows you from before, and she said you never were one for religion.
True.
But we know you as the guy that is for religion, and that's just confusing.
Well, it seems being dead kind of.
Yeah, seeing that changes things, I know.
Yeah.
But I saw you use fire, and you didn't use fire before.
Right.
How do you know where that comes from?
Not really, but if I get hurt, I can. It kind of just happens. as a reaction.
Yeah, it seemed like a reaction. I don't hold it against you by any means, because I attacked you, but...
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, it's just... I guess it's a little bit unsettling, knowing you from before and now knowing you with your fire abilities. I don't know yet what to make of it.
I'm not totally sure myself. I know why I'm back, but
yeah,
that's it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, talking to you now, you seem like Roth, just after being dead, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, where you seem to have some insight into the whole being dead thing. How come?
Well, it's an easy answer. I was dead.
What happened to you?
It was quick. I didn't... You see, I'm tiny, and I am in midst of a world full of big people, and things happen.
Right.
And I wasn't paying attention one time, and circumstances were bad as well.
Okay.
And I just... I think I maybe relied on my friends a little too much and then was careless. And they weren't quick enough. And it's all my fault.
I see. But what happened when you died? Do you remember?
I vaguely remember. It's escaping me more and more. But I vaguely remember there being... It was just weird. There were voices and people and... I saw some vision kind of thing.
Okay.
I still don't know what to make of it.
What did you see?
But it's... It's weird.
Okay.
I'd rather not talk about it for now.
That's fine. I mean, you remember more than me, so...
Yeah, it's really not much. It's escaping me every time I think about it.
Okay.
But, yeah. And I think the part that really is unsettling for me is that what came with it for being back alive. And that's why I worry that something came with it for you as well.
Nothing I notice, nothing I know of.
Okay. So you just have the obligation to protect your sister then?
It's not an obligation, it's why I came back.
Okay.
If it's an obligation, I laid it upon myself.
Okay, so you chose to come back yourself.
Yes.
Okay, that makes the whole thing a little bit less unsettling, but it's still kind of weird.
I'm not saying it's not weird. Not at all.
Yeah.
The really weird thing is. This sword, and he kind of it's across his lap, and I don't know where it came from. It's not the one I had before.
No, it's not, and it's also. Wait, hold on. You know that I have an ability. Can I hold the sword for a moment, or just touch it?
You can touch it.
Does it have a soul? Can I use Foresight?
No, it doesn't.
Okay. Whew. Thank you. I'm relieved.
What did you just do?
I checked if it was... I checked if it had a mind of its own. And it doesn't.
That's
which
good.
Which is a good thing.
But... Speaking of which, maybe not. That's a good roll. Let me try something.
I take a little bit of a distance, just a bit.
And he puts the sword on the ground and mumbles some words. And there's kind of a glow on his hands as he goes over the sword.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll be damned. There is a curse on that sword.
Oh, wow. Do you know what kind of curse?
Fuck.
Does he know that?
I don't know. Does he know that?
Him, come to the cleric.
There is some evilness within it.
That it's certainly not a good sword.
That would explain why it makes me go after whoever hurts me.
Huh.
It's a good sword, though. There's also some magic to it that makes it better, but that curse is bloody inconvenient.
Say the least.
Well, let's see if we can do something about it. And he just gets up and draws in air and bellows through the whole village, Ludo!
Do I hear this?
Yes. If you aren't fast asleep, you hear that.
I am not yet asleep.
I shake my ears.
And I also got really scared. I was not paying attention. I was doing my spells. I make towards the direction of the noise, but stealthily, because I don't know what's happening.
Okay, make a stealth roll.
That's really bad. I'm rolling so badly today. Stealth. 13.
Okay, and yeah, Roth spots you, and you see him sitting in front of his sword, and Ludo and Till kind of fluttering beside him, looking a bit flustered, shaking his
head.
That
was loud.
No.
Jeez.
What's up?
Ludo. This is a bit embarrassing, but my sword seems to be carrying...